About to get underway at Epping J.E. Moore Park, is it? Or is that West Preston, I believe? Anyway, the ball is kicked forward there, socket off the ground by Painter. White was well wrapped up in the tackle. There's been a push, says the umpire, and the free kick there is going to the number one for the Pingers, and that is Matthew DeMuff. He chips over the top and finds a teammate of his far on the wing. So it could be a big quarter here, they say. It's a premiership quarter, trying to fly over the back, and he has marked the ball. It's Patrick Gardner. Chips over the top, looking for Shepherd. Good mark, hands straight out. Didn't give Hurley much of a chance to dispose. Goes inboard, he's got Kefalis on there. Well intercepted, but couldn't get his hands on it. Was Doherty, number 19, coming through there. Totino, easy to pick up because he's got dreadlocks. Adams there tries to dispose long of the ball. Long gets a bit of a fumbled handball through on the bottom of the pack there for Epping. I think it might have been LaRossi trying to, he threw his head over the ball. It's not LaRossi, it's number one. That is Matthew DeMuff. DeMuff is on fire. Here we go. Moore gets a handball back off to Adams. Well tackled, and Kelly has been had a free kick paid against him. Well, there, Jacques.
A bit harsh there because he did everything he could and he made sure he rolled to the side. So he really tried his best, and I thought he should have been rewarded there, but unfortunately.
Seems you are able to drop to the knees and give yourself every chance of getting a free kick. So
if you play 40, that's Jake McDougall if it was play 40.
Jakey McDougall. No, look at that. There's Pat Gardner. So it was a good kick in there by Daniel Moore for Epping, and looking to get themselves on the board early in this third turn.
So it might have been player 22, Adams. And Adams for McLeod, also Adams for Epping. Both players have had a lot of the ball. And on that occasion, as you're saying, Patrick Gardner comes in. And there's something about that end and the other end. The balls just drift just to the left at the last minute.
Looking into the sun.
Missed to the near side. So McLeod ready to bring the ball back. Kicks it to himself. Does Seavers. Seavers chips it out in front of a running. Is it Martin? Yes, Martin marks it just inside the boundary line. Looks to go inboard. He's played on and decides to come down the line there to Story. But it goes over the back to Sayers, who takes a nice mark right in front of us. Handballs it across to Hurley. Hurley puts the ball out in front of Ryan Story. Kelly. Kelly centres the ball beautifully. Who's up for McLeod? A bit of a shove there from Kapow. And off the ground, who was that?
That is John Andrew there. He gets the Kangas' first goal of the third quarter. It is 8-9-57 at McLeod, 5-6-36 Epping.
It only took
3.5 minutes for McLeod to get on the board there. Great run of play, and it all started with the young man at fullback, Hayden Seavers.
And that's, what do you call that? Is it basketball terms, coast to coast?
Coast to coast.
Yeah, we're hearing a lot in football these days, don't we?
Yes, yes. So now Hayden Seavers looks like he might have moved himself to the quarterback position. Back in the centre now, no one on the offensive side for McLeod, all on the defensive. Shaw couldn't get his hands on it there. Totino gets a handball back to Moore for Epping. He kicks forward. Guido marking it. Guida, I think it is. Guida for Epping. Stab kick. He's found Shepherd on the lead. And not a bad little piece of play there for the Pingers.
Guida's had a bit of the ball in the first half, and he's very skillful. And hit him on the chest, lace up. So the Epping player there coming in.
He's got it.
Right hand go goal post and drifts back slightly and goes right through the middle. And is he up to 3 goals? Play 28, Peter Shepherd?
I think he might have kicked 3.
Yards at least.
Okay, score check there. What have we got? We've got Epping moving on to 6-6, 42. McLeod 8-5-51. Actually, it's got to be 8-9. Just on a slight angle here where I'm looking, it's 8-9-51.
57.
57, well, there you go.
Yes.
I'll be going to APSM where the AFL umpires go during the week to get re-evaluated. And it looks like I need a new pair.
So back in board now, it is the Rucks going at it, third man up with us. And there's been a chopping of the arm. Looks like it's going the way of Cruiser. He gives it off there to Moore. Moore comes back towards us. Delkus on the left, those green boots. Bit of a scrubby kick. Well fisted over the back there was Seavers. And a little toe poke there from LaRossi. Ran into his own teammate. It could be a holding the ball here. Adams is working his... Mitchell is trying to work his magic there to get a free kick. And umpire says no, and he'll throw it up. About 40 metres out from the Epping goals. So Cruiser gives his teammates every opportunity there. It's Jared Tilley seeing the ball over the boundary line.
Umpire brings it back in. Long and Cruiser fighting the sunlight there. Socket off the ground, but it was Bosch.
By Yarwood for McLeod. They've got a bit of a run on here with Story. Bangs it on that famous left boot of his, looking for Powell. Bounces off his chest. Here's Doherty. Goes one way, comes back the other. Gets round on the right. He's got Powell in board. Can he mark it? Oh, great stuff there from DeMouth by Epping, who managed to spoil it. It was Wood. Oh, and there's a tackle.
It's got to be ball.
Surely it could have been two. There it was, Andrew, out to Sayers. He's kicked it out on the full.
We're only human, and sadly, umpires made a mistake, and it's gone against McLeod there. They've been very good today. When you've been caught with the ball, it's been a free kick, but unfortunately, we didn't get it on that occasion. Epping bring it back down the near side in front of us. Up, they all jumped up, and it went over the back. Picked up by Epping, the ball spills free, and the umpires plucked out a free kick. Said it's a bit too high, I think. And McLeod plays a Mitchell. Mitchell there brings the ball into the forward 50, kicks it long in front of goal. Who's up? Kapow just spills free. The ball spills over the back, and was it off the ground? And I'm just trying to see if it was off the ground. Not sure if that was
Lachlan Considine.
Lockie Considine off the ground, and a very handy goal for McLeod. And McLeod regained that little buffer, moving on to 9-9-63, Epping 6-6-42.
Kicking straight this quarter they are. Aside from that little bit of a blemish from Doc Sayers, who is the man that's in the ruck, wins it down there to Andrew, handballs off to Shaw. Shaw looking for Long, bounces straight past him and goes in the hands of Wood for Epping. He's tapping it along with both hands and sees it over the boundary line.
Literally there. The old-fashioned paddle. one intention there.
Ball comes back in right on the 50-metre arc there. Long, little left hand down. Yarwood slipped over the ball. Painter was wrapped up there. Yarwood slaps it on the boot. Powell eats these for breakfast. And he certainly does. That was a great mark there.
Great mark. Just a little nudge, made sure his opponent was nudged to the side. Took a very good mark in front of goal.
Touch of style about the boy, isn't it?
There he is.
Goes about it very well. And if you nickname him Kapow, have you noticed the call earlier?
Pow, pow.
Pow, pow, is it? Not Kapow.
Or Kapow, or crash, bang, zap. Whack. All those Batman, as the commentator's curse comes on him. There's a bit of theatrics from the goal umpire.
Excited there, and we've come back to earth with that one.
Certainly have. It is 9 goals, 10, 64, McLeod. Leading Epping, 6-6, 42. We have been going about nearly 9 minutes in this quarter, I believe, as it is Keating for Epping to bring the ball back in. flying over the top there was Cruiser, but it was well punched down. Here's Yarwood. Good handball off. There it is.
That was percentage play, what the coaches would love to see. If you're behind the ball, behind the contest, let's make sure of it. Punch from behind.
Great run on play.
Was that Sayers from behind, punching the ball, still free?
Certainly was.
Handball came across to Yarwood and a beautiful kick on goal. And even the great attempt by Epping there, jumping into the air, wasn't good enough to stop that great goal by Yarwood. So McLeod, a little bit of a handy break here, 10-10.
70, and is it 5-6, 36?
No, 6-6, 42.
6-6, 42, apologies there. Free kick's been pulled out. It is going the way of McLeod. Skipper Shaw comes out onto the wing, and has it been a 50-metre penalty given away?
I'm not sure if it was running across the mark or
left. And another one.
You're giving me two. Well, he might be in the goal square here.
Bit of a lapse in concentration there.
I'm not sure. There's one player in the centre there with his hands on the hips. I don't know if he ran across the mark or said something, but as you pointed out, there's two 50-metre penalties there. And very handy for McLeod.
There it is. Their 11th of the day, kicked by their skipper Shaw. It is 11-10.
76.
There it is, and 6-6, 42.
There you go.
So now it is a 34-point ball game, and it looks like we've been travelling about 11 minutes and 41 seconds here in this third term. McLeod have kicked four goals this quarter, I believe, Jacques.
No, they've kicked done well this quarter.
No?
Yes.
Oh, hey. Someone has ran through the centre square a bit too soon, so Cruiser gives it off to Delkus. Weaves around one. He's looking for the big man in Shepherd. He's got it. Out-muscled Hurley there. The late inclusion for O'Brien.
You won't read that too often, that Hurley's been out-muscled.
Damien, that is.
I was talking about the Hurleys, both of them, Daniel and Michael. Don't get out muscle too often. Well, he's on a tight angle here for Epping. Comes in very deliberate, nice off the boot. Has he lined it up properly? The umpire says no. It's the far side for us, but the near side for the goal kicker on his right boot. McLeod don't waste any time here, bring it back into play, but it's a turnover right in front of goal, and Epping might have
kicked one.
McLeod pay there. We tried to bring it back into play, but the players might not have been ready, and there was a turnover, and Epping now have scored a goal. They move on to 7-7, 49, McLeod 11-10, 76. As we see player 56 come on for Epping, that's Tinsley, and they've taken off the goal kicker Shepherd and given him a little bit of a spell. So Tinsley moves on to the forward line there for Epping.
So the one up, one down, sock. Bit of a theme running with the McLeod ruckman here as, after a couple of years off, he's back here. It is Doc Sayers. It's one down by Cruiser. Painter with the intercept. Hands and knees there was Shaw trying to get a ball out. It goes with Andrew. Adams. Kelly. Back to Andrew. Doesn't bounce his way, but he gets his hand back on it here. Nankervis kicks inboard to the power direction. Here's a free kick. Where's it gone?
McLeod free kick holding on. And it might have gone to the man with us.
It is the beautifully bronzed Withers all the way from the Northern Territory. Plenty of sun up there at the moment.
So Withers from about 25, 30 metres out from goal. Walks in deliberately. Nice off the boot, but has that drifted also? We've seen a lot today drift to that side as well. Just drifts to the far side for him, and that goes through for one behind. So we've seen a couple miss on this end and the other end, both to this side, the grandstand side of the ground, by both players from both teams. Carl Corwin intercepts the ball from the kick in. Oh, McLeod play grab too high but not paid. Play on, ball spills free. Pack of players, Epping player tries to pick it up. Scrimmage develops, the umpire says, give it to me.
So we're 30 metres out here from the McLeod goals. Just ticked over the halfway mark of this third quarter. Jacques splashes the tonsils. Longy gets the ball down. Shaw, half a little chip quick, goes as far as Bean for McLeod. That is Joel Kidd, by the way. Adams, bit of a shank. He's plucked out long. Have a look at the ruckman here. He just swallowed that up. And this could be the big man's second for the day. If we went on the percentage basis before, I think Terry's got a good view of what the screen is showing now. Chris Long from here, he's been going at 84% this season from this exact angle. There's a man who kicked it to him. Adams is coming off for a break to release Steve Kelly. Long comes in. Here we go. We've heard it. Terry's seen this one before. Oh, he certainly has. No one gets around him. He has to chase the high fives himself. But there it is. That is McLeod's 12th goal. They go to 12-11-83, 7-7-49 Epping. 16 and a half minutes gone here. McLeod, they have the 34-point lead. Could this be enough for them to bring home the 4 points today? Umpire has the ball back in the centre now. One of three field umpires today. It's some big ground to cover. Core wins the ball back to himself. We notice we're saying his name now as he had a bit of a spell. Yarwood ducks and weaves through a couple. Kicks out in the white direction and he marks. So he's right on the edge of the 50 arc here. Kicking to the power direction. Couldn't get his hands on it. Andrew shirts one on the left boot. There's another one. Here come the Kangas. I think that's Johnny Andrews' third for the day. They go to 13-11-89, a 40-point lead now. Epping 7-7-49. Here we go, Long, the man who kicked the second last goal. Bit of a fresh air there from Core. He's still giving himself every opportunity to win the contest there. Throwdown tackle, it goes to LaRossi. That was Santoro for Epping. Kicks forward there in the Gardner direction. He's beaten by Mitchell. Mitchell gets a handball out. There's Long again. He's eating it up for breakfast here. A kid, Mitchell, Yarwood, Story. Releases Nankervis, assesses his options, kicks to a leading white, punched from behind there by the Epping player. On hands and knees was Doherty for McLeod. Back to Story, covered a lot of ground. White looks inboard. Andrew couldn't get his hands on it, but he's been able to get a bit of space here. Kicks round, and has he found Kelly? No, he has not. Kefalis there mopping up for Epping. And there it comes out as they switch the ball back in the white direction. He ends up winning the contest here. Slaps it on the boot. Elch on his own. He's taking a mark there. Bit of a hard angle. But this to be the Kangaroos' 14th goal. They are kicking away here. Really making up for some of that lost percentage they have gone missing over the last few weeks. Considine comes in. Kicks truly. There it is. 14-11-95, 7-7-49. It is a 46-point ball game here. And McLeod have kicked, I think it is 11 of the past 14 goals.
Yes, since quarter time, both teams have kicked a lot straighter. There have been the odd behind with those... as we say, both to the scoreboard end, the Sydney Road end, or the Sydney end, as you mentioned, and also the Melbourne in. Towards the grandstand, there's a bit of a breeze just coming our way, and a lot of shots have just missed at the last minute.
So here it is. It is Epping getting a clearing kick now. They'll be looking for Gardner here. Well punched over the back there was Mitchell. Gardner picks it up again. Great tackle by Mitchell. It's Guida. He handballs it back to Kelly. Kelly off to Nankervis. Back to Martin. Chip kick out wide. He's got White on the lead. Puts the arms out. Plays on straight away. Little kick over the top to Kelly. They've got a little bit of a run on here, McLeod. Kelly kicks to a leading... Oh, was that Doherty or Vespremi? Sorry. There's Elch. Elch slaps it on the left. And it's bounced through for a behind. So it is 14-12, 96, McLeod, 7-7, 49, Epping. Going about 20 minutes here in this final third quarter. Sorry, just preempting, getting a bit excited and ahead of myself there.
How did this name Elch come about?
You'd have to ask Elch himself. He fancies himself. Elch has played some good footy this year. Great mark there by Shane Wood. Just used his body. Handballs off to Tilly. Tilly inboard there to McMahon. And now he releases Staveley. Takes a bounce. Puts it on the boot. Looking for Guida. Guida versus Nankervis. Guida's first to the ball. And Nankervis helps him see it over the boundary line. It's going to be thrown in about 70 away from the Epping goals. And we've gone 21 and a half minutes in this quarter.
A rare fumble there by Guido has been very good.
Certainly has. So the umpire brings it back in here. It is Long versus Tinsley. Cruiser might be just having a little bit of a rest here. Epping get a clearing kick out. It's going in the goal direction. Seavers one-on-one there with Gardner, and they see it over the boundary line, and it's just going to be thrown in.
Numbers running back there. The ball comes back in. Almost in front of goal here. There's a handball out by Epping. Does it hit a target? No. Turnover. McLeod player there brings the ball back down the line. Found Scooter. Great diving mark there by Scooter. Scooter looks inboard. Just over the head there of Vespremi. Buttering up his Doherty. His ball spilled free by number 20. Oh, he's hard at it. Oh, Adams against Adams there. Player 20 Adams are being almost set on the McLeod variety of Adams. Both two tough players. The umpire's asking the guys going for the ball here to step back a bit. Ball up, ball comes to ground, picked up by Seavers. Seavers, good handball, finds Martin. The umpire's saying play on, plays advantage to McLeod. The ball's on three now, it's affected by the sun, but picked up by Vespremi, handballs it. He gets the ball back, comes along and centres the ball right up there for Kapow, Pow Pow, but the ball spills just short of him. And Epping moved the ball across to the far side.
McLeod
were just about to bring the ball back into play, and the umpire finds a free kick for
Guida. It is. Just a little nudge Nankervis game, and the umpire was right onto it. Chip in board there, finds the number 18 in Cameron. Plays on, he's looking for Gardner. Gardner there. Beaten by Adams, who's got time to mop up. Little Shepherd given by Yarwood. Adams goes through a few options and ends up finding Withers in the middle. He sells a bit of candy, fakes with a handball. Now he goes back to Adams. Covered a lot of ground. Can run the kid, do they say. Looks like Zaharakis. Ball was touched, so it's play on. Off to Andrew. He's going for his fourth. Is it in there? No, it's not. Bit of a letdown there for the... McLeod Kangaroos, as it is 14-13, 97, 7-7, 49. Been travelling 24 minutes in this quarter there, Joe.
Like you said, Adams, well, he kept his feet firstly, but then he ran from the half-back flank to the half-forward flank, pressing to create an opportunity there. As the ball comes back into play, Epping chips the ball across into, still inside the their back 50. They kick it now here outside the 50, find player 17 in Delkis. He's had a lot of the ball. He finds a man free in LaRossi. Ball bounces in front of him, he can't grab it. In comes Painter. Painter, both trying to get possession of the ball. LaRossi wins it, and LaRossi throws his head back in what appeared to be a high tackle, and LaRossi wins a free kick. He chips it forward in front, doesn't find his man. And I can say this being an Essendon supporter, Lloyd in his day when he had a patch where he dived and got found out, that was equivalent to one of Manny Lloyd's dives. Peter Shepherd's a lot better than that. But anyway, he's won a free kick, and we know he's a very good goal kicker. So if he allows enough for it, he will kick another goal. So he comes in, Peter Shepherd, he's allowed a little bit too much. He's gone to the far side.
Oh, what a mark.
A one-on-one contest there.
Gardner.
So Gardner on a very, very tight angle, but not very far out from goal. Umpires making sure the McLeod players don't get too close. And he will run around.
If I was him, I'd be facing the other way.
One step out and one behind.
7 goals, 8 points, 50R Epping. They trail by just under 8 goals. It's a 47-point margin McLeod's way. They've really kicked away in this quarter.
And Kefalis comes back on to replace Adams for Epping. Kefalis, another big ball winner for Epping today.
Seavers kicks to himself, plays on, looking for Martin. Not a bad mark there taken into that sun. And we've seen a few of the players holding their hands up over their eyes trying to give themselves a bit better vision. So Martin goes to Yarwood, hesitates a bit, handballs over to no one in particular, but it's going to go back to Martin. These two waxing lyrical together. Nankervis, Hurley, over the top. There's Kidd. Here's a running vest, Premi, got a bit of pace on, inboard to Withers, handball wasn't the best. Gardner wrapped up in the tackle there, and the umpire is going to throw it up right near the centre circle as we can't have too much time left here. 27 minutes gone in this third term. Epping, clearing kick there by Cameron into their forward line, and coming back at centre half back was the skipper for McLeod, Shaw. Player being told to move back off the mark. Kicks it wide in the Seaver's direction. He's got a bit of time here. Handball's over the top. Could that be a downfield? No, it wasn't. Seaver's gets up. Vez Premi back in board. Painter jumps up there. Martin. Here's Vez Premi again. Kicks in the forward direction. Goes as far as Delkis for Epping. He chips over there. That looks like it's found Cameron for Epping. Right in the centre circle. On the left boot. He's looking for Shepherd. But Hurley beats his man in front of the ball there. And he chips over to Yarwood. Yarwood's now got it. Assessing his options. Comes back in board to Andrew. Kicked a couple of goals today, had a few possessions, he'd be happy with that. Martin, bit of a hurried handball, coming through there was LaRossi for Epping. Oh, he's beaten a couple here, he's still got one more to beat, is Andrew. Holding on to him, and...
I'd argue, how did he get rid of it? He had the ball and just let it go when he got tackled, but anyway, free kick and nice intercepting mark there by Martin on the half-back flank. Martin goes inboard, brings it to centre-half back. Finds Seavers. Seavers looking out for options. He looks like he's going to go straight down the middle. And unfortunately, that ball's short into the Epping hands. Turnover there. Epping player then looking for his options in the forward 50. Can't see too many players running for him. Decides to go long. Up there, is that Shepherd? No, yes, it is Shepherd. Ball comes to ground. He still holds his feet. Shepherd, strong player. Goes for goal, and it's going to go over the players' heads in the goal square, and he might have drilled it. Yes, he has. Shepherd putting down for another goal. A score check in the AFL.
Yeah.
Adelaide 57, lead the Swans 52. Mm. And what stage of the game is that?
Final quarter.
That's final quarter in the AFL. So it could be an upset brewing there for Port Adelaide. There you go. So Epping hit back now with 8-6, I can't see the scoreboard.
8-6, 54? Sorry, 8-8, 56 to 14-13, 97, a 41-point. So a big cruiser fist down there coming through was Cameron Campbell, I think that is, for Epping. McLeod players are holding them up, and a free kick too high is going away. The man on the bottom, John Andrew, he handballs out to Story. Story now blazes down the wing. Weiss forced his player under the ball, sits up for him now. Bounces straight away. Withers moving over there, tries to give a shepherd. White takes another bounce, and it's just faded right across for a behind. So great run on of play there, McLeod. They just couldn't put the icing on the cake. It is 14-98 to 8-8-56. It is exactly a 7-goal lead here, 42 points, as we're just under half an hour going in this quarter. Big quarter, lots of goals kicked. He's looking for Cruiser. Shaw over the back. Oh, Sayers giving away a free kick. There's the siren. 14-14, 98 to 8-8-56. McLeod with a 7-goal lead. Yeah, that AFL match is going.
Port lead by 19 points. 23 minutes.
Game over, I would say. Fourth quarter here at Epping Recreation Reserve. There's 36 men out there at the moment getting their Saturday afternoon recreation as Epping take on McLeod in this round 10 Northern Football League Division 1 clash. No score as of yet in the fourth quarter.
I was just saying off air, the message was clear from the McLeod coach to don't drop the intensity. There's been plenty of games this year from all clubs where a handy lead has been wilted away, so we can't afford that to happen.
Sure. Big one last week in Division 2. Whittlesea came from a... they were 10 goals down to win by a point against Big North Heidelberg there. So here's Adams. He's pushed off the ball there, or bodied off the ball, I should say, by Cora's. The umpire is going to say it's mine, and I'll throw it up about 70 out from McLeod's scoring end. Up it goes. Coming through was the third man there for Epping Wood. White throws himself on the bottom of the ball. Epping get it clearing handball out now. This is Tontino. Shaw throws his hands at it, was able to intercept. Handball's over the top now to Kelly. He gives another one, a handball there to Doherty. Doherty off to a painter, that looks like.
I believe so. Yep.
Those baggy shorts. Oh! Was the... there was a few of the Epping contingent there calling for a bit of maybe too far, but they've ended up with the ball anyway. A bit of a poor decision by Painter kicking it out on the full.
He's run out of room there and kicked it over the line. Ball comes back in and it's a big high pack, but ball comes to ground, picked up by McLeod. Is it Withers? Comes forward of him. Johnny Andrew gets the handball out, and a sweeping handball by Kelly Fine Story, who had to work very hard for the ball. Ball spills free, picked up by Epping. Oh, look out.
They're on
Gardner.
Here. Gardner.
Switches play.
So he was looking out towards Totino, and Kelly's actually going to end up with it here after a bit of hard work from the McLeod skipper Shaw. He stops, steadies, looks at his options, find Withers inboard. He plays on. Onto the right foot, multi-talented.
I was just going to say, I didn't know he was a right footer, and that was one of a very good kick.
So it was marked by Doherty off to Painter, I think it might have been, or Adams. Look at that. Hits up, pal. He's 15 metres out.
Just sheer strength.
And he's going to have the opportunity to get McLeod across that magical 100 there. And you don't see many teams lose after they crack that.
That's what Dermot Bruton says, and I concur with him. Most teams who get to 100 first rarely lose a football match. Read the flight of the ball well. He comes in. Pow, 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 as you say, and makes no mistake.
Here he goes. So it's McLeod, 15-14, 104 to 8-8-56. Epping. This game, I'd say, is well and truly over here. and Epping, with only just one win on the board, they would be looking at potential relegation unless they can win a few of the next eight to come. The long, big fist down there. It was Epping getting the clearance, and it went as far as La Rossi. He had three McLeod players to beat, and it was Painter. Look at that sneaky little kick. Off to White. He puts it on the left. Is that going through? Oh, it is. He's thoroughly relished and enjoyed his opportunity getting forward this year, kicking a few goals. That might have been his second, I think, for the day, as McLeod get their second successive goal here. It is 16-14, 110, a nine-goal lead now, 8-8-56, Epping.
Well, just as that ball came out of the centre, it was coming out of the centre square and looked like an Epping player was about to run on and pick up the ball. We had three converging McLeod players force the turnover, and the waiting numbers got the ball across to, I think it was Painter, off the side of the boot, a deliberate kick to find Scooter, and he made no mistake. And the ball comes out of the middle again, this time by Adams. Adams kicks the ball. The ball spills free in front of players. McLeod players didn't grab that one. That comes to an Epping player who goes for the boundary line. Ball's kept in a play. Finds 25, which is McMahon. McMahon finds a teammate in La Rossi. La Rossi goes down the line. They all jump up for it. No one marks it. Picked up by Mitchell. Mitchell swings a handball across to Seavers. Seavers finds Winter. Winter goes across the side of the ground, finds a running...
Oh, I think that's Kidd. Here comes Kidd, the man with the big biceps, looking for Elch. Elch! He's got it.
And Elch afterwards.
Yes.
Very strong mark.
That was a good mark there by the man with the long hair. Those who have little of it are very envious of those with hair. So he's going to line up right on, just coming in over that 50 metre arc. It's a reasonable kick.
It's a bit of a floater, but it's very, very accurate. Right through the haydiddle.
And there it is. That is McLeod's 17th goal. They are 17-14, 116. Kicked three successive goals here. Epping yet to trouble the scorers in this last quarter. I don't think it's actually gone inside their 50. They are still remain on 8-8-56.
Yes, good response to the instructions from the coach not to let up. Kicking the first three unanswered goals there to close the door on Epping, but the game's not over yet. Well, it will be as far as the game, but percentage-wise, McLeod need to keep working hard because we know at the end of the year, percentage will count for a lot.
So it is a 10-goal lead at the moment. Long and Cruiser hit it to each other. It is DeMolf who wins it there. O'Neill handballs back to DeMolf. Fumbles there. He goes back to O'Neill. Wheels round. He's a backman, but he's kicked like a backman. As on the last line of defence there, I think that was Kidd. He switched it across. He's found a running player in Adams. Adams blazes away. Martin plays on. Andrew runs through a bit of traffic. Back to Martin. Here he is. Runs right through the centre of the ground. It is an open forward line. Painter forced his opponent to ground. Here comes Powell. Picks the ball up. Slaps it on the boot. Oh, on hands and knees there was Cameron Campbell. Here's Elch again. Can't pick it up cleanly. Wheels round. Bang. There it is.
How about that?
That is McLeod's 18th for the day.
They kick out now to a 66-point lead. It is 18-14, 122. Epping, 8-8-56. Did have a chance to score there, but the big Michael O'Neill, the raking halfback who's playing a bit of a defensive forward role on Kane Shaw today, just unable to get that that score through the big sticks for Epping, and McLeod just hit him up on the return.
And a special hello to Brian Bottomley, who we had a chat before the game, said, look, we really need a 6-goal margin for the percentage, so if all things stay as they are, we will get that at least a 6-goal margin. So Brian will be very happy tonight.
I'd like another five goals and Epping to kick 2 points because I've got the 94-point margin in their winning margin raffle today.
I was sure there was going to be logic to that statement, and I know what it is. Plus ticket.
That is correct. So McLeod here get a kick out to the wing, and it goes to Dalkus. Intercept marked by Shaw. Hasn't he been good today? Passes off to the relative of his by the name of Seavers. Takes a bounce, kicks it in forward. Oh, receivers, we hear Terry there as Elch on hands and knees. There was Long White. He snapped it. Could he be getting a bit hungry? No! What a great centering kick. He's found.
And he's played on.
And he's kicked it. There it is. That is five goals straight here to nothing. Could this margin be getting a bit closer to what we would like? It is now a 72-point margin, 12 goals there. It is McLeod, 19-14, 128. Epping is still yet to kick a goal or even trouble the score as this quarter.
And say a special hello to the fastest trombone in the West.
Oh, it is Mr. Stephen Cottier. As we're about to tick over 10 minutes, and the way McLeod are going, could this be a 12-goal quarter?
Could well be. They certainly have what they call a run on. They've certainly got momentum in the run at the moment.
Swings and roundabouts, and at the moment it seems like the roundabout is just going from the McLeod goals back to the centre circle. Here it is again. Kaur gets a bit of a fumbled handball, goes as far as Dalkus. There's Demouf for Epping. He's found Shepherd. Hasn't touched the ball this quarter. Here it is. Marks plays on, and he's kicked that one right through. No, the behinds.
Just grazed the post. There's that little breeze.
And there's that point, first of 2 points we were after from Epping in this encounter. Seavers gets a kick back in. Andrew couldn't mark. Shaw, front and centre, McCabe style, kicks forward there to Doherty. He ends up fumbling, but he's awarded the mark anyway. Running through with Shaw again. He's just really stepped up this last quarter. And there is Long. Handballs off to Vez Premi, dribbles it through.
That's as unselfish as you'll get from 15 metres out.
And that is their 20th goal.
Would you ever see Tony Lockett do that?
You won't see too many people 15 metres out from goal handball the ball, and that's real team effort there by Longy. Well done.
He's had a very, very solid game today, the big man. Taking a rest down forward, did the right thing. Handed the ball off to the player running past, and McLeod now, 20 goals, 14, 134, a 77-point margin, 8-9, 57, Epping here at the Recreation Reserve.
Well, we wouldn't have seen this margin at quarter-time nor half-time, so the second half has been fantastic by McLeod.
Really busted open here as Painter sockers off towards the wing. Yarwood was the first to get there. Kicks over the top, and he has found his teammate there, I believe, in Sayers. Seavers runs on, takes a bounce, sells a bit of candy, kicks down there to White, couldn't hold on to it. Fry picks it up now. There he is, throws it on the left out to the fat side. He's looking for Long. Here's Powell. Coming through, Wood there for Epping. Happy to see it over the boundary line.
Just a little topo go over the line there.
It is. So 12 and a quarter minutes gone, and we've seen six goals this quarter, have we?
We've seen quite a few goals this quarter. We've seen at least six goals this quarter.
So ball thrown back in.
Long, Andrew White. Kicks a check side the wrong way to Tino. Marks there for Epping. Just gone the distance. Handballed off to Campbell. He was tackled there. To Tino. Falls over the ball again. And it's been a push down there by...
He signaled throw, but paid a
Vez Premi. Bit of mix. He goes there to Guida. Inboard there, he finds a teammate of his, and it goes to Santoro. Santoro back to LaRossi there, and well marked there by Kefalis, I think it is. He goes back to Santoro. Santoro's looking for Shepherd, couldn't mark. Well punched away there by Hurley for McLeod. He's looking to see the ball over the boundary line here, and Shepherd tries to keep it in, but it fades over into the tennis court direction.
Good effort there by Hurley to spoil. Shepherd has had a good run today, and very hard to outmuscle or outposition Shepherd, who's quite a solid kid. Umpire's found a free kick. The ball came back into play, and looks like it was too high against an Epping player, and Epping will have a shot on goal. He handballs it off straight away. Not sure which Epping player drives it towards the boundary line.
Has that gone through for a goal, has it?
No.
No, there's been a free kick.
A free kick near the behind post. Maybe he's made a push from that position. And we've got Epping now on the far side there. Is that Cruiser having a shot on goal?
Yeah, could be. Or is it... I think that might be.
I think it's play 15. Cruiser, he's had a shot on goal and he's nailed that one. That's Epping's first goal for the quarter. I'll be happy to know they've moved on to... Is it 9-9-63? And McLeod are on 20 goals.
18. 20. It is 2014 134. So it is a 71-point ball game here. Back in the middle now, it is Sayers, part-time ruckman, fists it forward to White, throws it on the right. It looks okay. Here's Martin. He's had a bit of it today, and he's been pinged for holding the ball there.
The only guy going, well, anyway, that's harsh, but he's been pinged.
So it's Cameron Campbell for Epping. Finds a teammate by the name of O'Neill there, goes it back in board to Guida. Guida is looking for Shepherd, but he gets Kefalis. Kefalis there, he goes back to Moore, check side from LaRossi, and just seen over the boundary line there. Last line of defence by one Hayden Sievers.
Yes, I thought Epping there didn't make the most of that opportunity, but once again that drifted towards the near pocket, and the umpire will bring it back into play. Sayers brings the ball to ground, picked up by Hurley, quicks it, snaps it onto the boot, just goes over the head of players. We've got Story there being nudged under it by LaRossi. And the McLeod player Core came in there and gave the Luke Hodge, don't argue. LaRossi's getting up, he's okay.
Here we go, Sayers and Cruiser at it again, and Sayers just sees the ball over the boundary line there. 16 and a half minutes gone here. Could be a little bit of a long quarter. Had a couple of goals kicked. It's in the Epping forward 50 here. Cruiser, big left fister down there, and letting it skiff off his boot. Well, that was Daniel Santoro. Tried to soccer it, and it's ended up with the man by the name of Nankur. So look at that. He sucked him into it and was able to run around him looking for Core. Over the back, Martin.
Very nice, Mark.
Patrick marked it there. He's found Mitchell. Turns around, kicks on the run to a running Ryan Story. Here's a never-ending story. He goes behind the goals. And it is... I thought I heard an echo there. I can hear a man next door.
Saying behind after I said behind.
Yeah, he was well behind.
He was well behind. So it's back out to a 12-goal margin. It's 2015,
135, 9-9-63. Epping trailing McLeod, as I just said, by 12 goals. It looks like it might be Brenton Keating again bringing the ball back in. He's looking for Adams. He's taking a good mark there. Had a bit of it today, being one of Epping's better performers. Looking inboard for Wood. Finds it in front of Sayers. Turns around, plays straight on. Looking for O'Neill. Well punched away there by Story. And it's a race to the ball there between Gardner and Story. Gardner gets there first, but forgets to pick it up. Free kicks come out a little bit too high, going the way of Gardner. And Kidd has led his man there, Kafalas, get one on to the ball on his own. But getting back a bit of support there from Core. He passes off to Seavers, kicks inboard to Shaw. The Cousins have waxed lyrical a bit today as Shaw, often Ankervis, Sayers, Withers, Long. Oh, look at that. There's the NT boys. There's one of those no-look handballs. Vez Premi, Yarwood, here's for his second. Can he kick it across the face and through for a behind? McLeod just letting some potential goal opportunities go through here as it's 2016, 137.
Now, how many more goals do they need to kick for your win-loss ticket to get up?
We have a... Well, did that go out on the full or behind? That's one.
I thought it was... No, it's behind. We're just waiting for the ball to come back into play now. Here it is.
137. I needed... I'd really like another 21 points. I hope Ralph held on to my ticket. Could be $100 coming my way, if so. Here we go, Epping trying to clear the ball out. There is Wood for Epping. Solid performer today. Handballs back to LaRossi. Breaks the line a bit and kicks it up in the direction there of Gardner. Just went straight past him. Coming through was Hurley. Stood up in the tackle, but was well tackled by Seavers. Nankervis is there to throw some support. Tackles O'Neill pretty well. And he's
been...
He's had a free kick paid against him, penalised there for throwing the ball.
I thought it should have been holding the ball anyway against it being played, took the McLeod player on, but not rewarded. LaRossi gets the handball across, finds Tilly. Tilly kicks the ball inboard, up they go. Ball comes to Graham, McLeod player grabs the ball, slips, handballs it across there, finds his man Sayers. Sayers sweeping handball. Excuse me. Ball spills free. Story's trying to, he's just overrun the ball. He was running that fast, Story. He's overrunning, he's managed to get back into the pack and it's all wrapped up. And the umpire says, give it to me.
Here we go, we've ticked into time on now. 20 and a half minutes. 73-point lead to McLeod. Handball goes out there to Santoro and he's won a free kick. So the Epping player is going to get this one on the wing. Handballs back to Delkus. With it now, kicks to a leading O'Neill, is it? No, sorry, that is the number 51, Shannon Emerton. 56. 56, Robert Tinsley. Haven't seen a lot of him today. I could have been at a different game, though. Maybe he's had a whole heap of possessions, but... He kicks a 9-iron, and I'd say that's going to be punched through. So they all fly up, but no one actually comes away with it. Now, it was Kidd, handballed off to Martin. Martin calls his teammates forward. He's looking for Mitchell. This ball's just possibly going to go over the boundary line, and it does.
Yes, they all went up there, and the ball just carried the pack, and McLeod were able to... I thought going to spool through, but they said no, we've got enough space, time and space, and they were able to clear it out of the defence. Ball comes back into play, Epping play, grabs the ball, it could have been LaRossi, the way they're looking at the kicking style there, bringing it back in there. Turnover, Hurley runs, grabs the ball, puts it onto his left boot, comes free of the pack. Epping players trying to run onto it. McLeod player runs in and wraps him up. No, the ball spills free, but this time the umpire says no. It is wrapped up now. Give it to me.
22 and a half minutes gone here. McLeod have a 73-point lead. Sayers fists it down to Martin. Back to Sayers on the left boot. He's got Mitchell out here with a bit of time, but he's being chased down very quick by DeMouth. Back to Sayers. He's worked it very hard there. Here comes Adams. Puts it on the left boot. Kicks it inboard. He's looking for Doherty. Comes through. Couldn't keep his feet. There's Campbell for Epping. Hands and knees. Andrew. Busting through the pack was Vez Premi. Great intercept there by Epping, and it comes out to Totino. He takes a bounce. He gets a beautiful shepherd there from a teammate and hits up, I think that's Kafalas. Kafalas turns around, he's looking for O'Neill. Can he mark? No, he can't. Seavers out-muscled in there. Sorry, that was Gardner for Epping. Sievers runs back to where he was... runs back on the direction where he was going. Core goes inboard, finds Vesprimi, composes, switches across there to Yarwood.
That was a great effort there by Sievers to, on the one-on-one on the back line of our muscle leads back forward.
So Yarwood went into Nankervis and he ran on and kicked it to Mitchell. He's got wide on the lead. There it is.
It's getting very dark in that pocket.
Certainly is out there. They could do with a few lights.
What are we, one day off the
shortest day
yesterday, the 21st of June.
The winter solstice.
Solstice, that's correct.
Which means we're 6 months away from the summer solstice.
That's right. So the days get longer, but in about a month's time or 2 months' time we'll get...
And we all get older as those days get longer. In comes White. Oh, and that's gone behind. 2017, 137 to Epping, 9963. It is a 74-point margin now, and I don't think McLeod have actually kicked a goal for the past 15 minutes. Kicked a few behinds. Lot played between the arcs. Epping bring it back in. Nankervis and O'Neill. Well tackled there, O'Neill, after a front and centre from Doherty for McLeod. Nankervis now doing the tackling, and the umpire says, give it to me. I'll throw it up here, just to the left of the Epping interchange bench.
That was Kidd, I think, not too heavy. Runs away with it, Martin. Martin squares up the ball to the far side.
Good kick there from Yarwood.
Just nudged underneath the ball, and the ball's gone over the pack, and it's on the far side there in the pocket from McLeod, and we need to kick a couple of goals to get that win-loss ticket up. Then we need to find a win-loss ticket.
There's Vesprimi.
Here we go.
So Vesprimi snaps right across the face of goal, and Doherty just couldn't get there quick enough. 25 minutes,
40 seconds gone. The time ticks down here on this Saturday afternoon round 10 match. McLeod are going to go to 3 wins here, and they'll edge ahead of Lower Plenty and leaving Epping on 1 game. 1 win, I should say. Kick back in ball to Andrew. That's surely a free kick.
It's a bit high.
O'Neill, Andrew was following the ball, and he ran into O'Neill.
Civarella, soft. You know, hearing some of the crowd say soft, but I don't think it was soft. That got him pretty high. Johnny Andrews doesn't play soccer, and he doesn't lie down unless he's been hit. But he hasn't moved. I hope he's all right. It's a little bit unnecessary in this stage of the game. I'm wanting to make him earn it, but when the players running, the two players running at each other head on, we've got to be very careful we don't hit someone above the shoulders. Medical staff there just making sure he's okay. Surrounded by players at the minute, so we can't see. He seems to be sitting on back on his backside now, and he's trying to help him up. He's holding his neck. Seems to have a bit of a sore neck. I think he might be coming from the ground for a bit of a spell.
He's a tough boy.
Yeah. He's not feeling too well, but he'll just come out for a check, and the medical staff will run the check from him and make sure he's okay. Vesprimi brings the ball, centres the ball into the 50, but that's intercepted there by Epping. The numbers back there, Epping, on this occasion. Umpire saying play on. Move the ball on, and Epping player certainly does that. Brings it to the near side here. And is that ball marked there by Kidd? Yes, it is. There we go. He finds Story, kicks the ball backwards a little bit just to keep possession of the ball. Story there. Goes down the line there, just over the top there of Mitchell. Comes back to Mitchell, handballs it off to Withers. Withers brings the ball across to Hurley to Vesprimi. Vesprimi moves the ball on, does not hit a target on this occasion, and comes to
Guido. Here he is for Epping. Bounces straight away before it even had a chance to take two steps. Nankervis caught up to him pretty quick, and he just kicks a bit of a shank into the forward line. There is Kefalis. Kicks out to Totino. Runs around the big man there in Sayers. Totino kicks right across the face. A behind.
He used the umpire as a blocker. But unfortunately for him, was dragged it across the far side and one behind to Epping.
So Epping get another score. They are 9-10-64. McLeod 2017-137. A 73-point lead there for the Kangaroos.
The bench down there for Epping. We've got Cruiser in front of us on the bench. We've got Daniel Moore and of course Peter Shepherd. Two of their better players there in Cruiser and Shepherd. And that's the final siren. Good win to McLeod. Score check.
It is 2017-137, 9-10-64, 73-point victors for McLeod. Final scores here. And there we go, a three-goal victory to the Power in the AFL. Over and out, hey?